Always out of step, always out of time. be true that we are different? Is your God really not mine? Can it be true that we are separate? Always on a step, always on a step.
Some, I dare say, in the process of being made. A 5,000-year civilization, I say. Somehow, Mr. Delroy does not seem to include proper coffee training. Mr. Delroy was absolutely furious, but he buys his time, and a few years later, he's invited over to England. And Mr. Churchill takes him around by helicopter and shows off the agricultural blessings of England. Mr. Nehru, being the Indian that he is, is ever ready to find fault with England and Mr. Churchill. And he spots a man in the field, squatting, in the height of ecstasy, believing himself. He then turns to Mr. Churchill. Mr. Churchill!
Oh,
landlords abound, where students are found. Claiming
freedom for and 200 a court. But what you do is the law of the system. Get one place to hide your face. We say you're free in this strange country. Until the signs are gone, then you can have your bed. The signs are outside and also in your head. Until the signs are gone, then you can have your bed. The signs are outside and also in your head. Until the signs are gone, then you can have your bed. The signs are outside and also in your head. Until the signs are gone, then you can have your bed. The signs are outside and also in your head.
We continue this discussion, dear people. Firstly, our country. Discrimination, inequality, detention without trial, other people feeling superior than other people. How long must we suffer this pain of apartheid and oppression? How long?
What about our campus?
Take situation in our campus. Kidney problem, accommodation problem, limitation of African students.
Boycott!
right, you have to suffer like dogs. No, worse than dogs. Dogs don't think when they suffer. We just suffer. Why can we let other human beings make us suffer like dogs? We are not dogs. Hasn't anyone done? We've waited long. We've waited long.
It was just a peaceful boycott. A bit of relief from our study. Why did it have to end this way? No. A boycott should be taken seriously. A lot of students don't take anything seriously. They don't know the freedom songs. They don't march with us. We're not united. That is why it's so easy for the police.
Easy for the police? I wonder. I guess they are also victims of this oppressive government, being forced into using group violence against students. And in the process, portrayed as nothing more than police gangsters.
It's never easy to give up your way of living or other ways of doing things. I feel so scared. Did I come here for this? What about those students? I mean those that force us to march with them. They don't explain anything properly to us. We just have to follow like sheep.
Bayanya, there's no time to explain.
Why use force? Then we have to face me. And all we want is to be let alone.
We don't have a platform or a means for peaceful protest. The state does not provide this. So what do we do in the meantime? I say that the protest must get more and more radical.
This is not time for selfishness. Now is the time to stand up and be calm down.
And gun down by police bullets?
That is the price for freedom.
This is too, clever. They're all so clever, but never when it matters.
I'm scared. I really do not know what my true feelings are. All this talk, nobody helps. It's just talk. It all sounds so reasonable. So reasonable, this justification of everything. But something is wrong. Terribly wrong somewhere. And no one has told me where to begin. We react, but we never respond.
It's like looking on when someone is being raped. And all you can talk about is whether she provoked the men or not. I saw a rape of sorts. I was walking home when I saw a man being beaten up, whilst well-dressed men and women stood around, discussing whether he was really the back snatcher or not. They were not even sure. I was horrified, and I asked them to stop while I called the police and ambulance. They looked at me disgusted, while little boys ran in from nearby houses to join in the fun of seeing a man be beaten up, innocent or not. The police came first and took the man away. And in the meantime, I took our names and number plates of all those that had beaten up the man, so that he could learn assault charge later on. All the crowd could do was look at me and yell, "Hey, Kappa lover, is that what they teach you at varsity? To love Kappas?" And words were getting into the way of action. The beating of the man was not action. It was the years and years of being told how to act that took over and made beasts out of so-called decent people. The words of our past disguised this action. We have to be so careful to see clearly. It's easier not to.
Thank you.
when you're tired of the day's frenetic walking, into the late, late night, you are ray.
Great.
By whom?
By whom?
By your very own protector. In one night, out of sight. Or is it morning? Early, early morning. When the doors are closed to you, and sleep is refused.
Refused.
So the rape begins long before you are seen, before the doors are closed to you, sometime when you were born.
So who is right? No easy answer left. So we talk about this truth.
really know the way. It keeps us much less radical. No need to think every day.
We have to destroy our leaders by refusing to act in ways that are intelligent, by dealing with just the facts.
Thank you. Love, love, love. the same in all love, in all love.